Okay, good evening. It's 7 o'clock. This is the meeting of the advisory committee on Tuesday, May 21st. First item on the agenda is transfer requests. I got an additional one when I walked in the door, and I can go over that, but let's first start with the transfer request that we began discussing last week. So just as background, a company called Whitewater handles the processing of sewage at the wastewater treatment plant, and that there's like a long-standing agreement between the school district and the town where the school district pays 85% of the monthly usage charges and the town pays 15%. And so based on usage this year, that budget line, which is 440, is overdrawn. And so basically for the next 3 months, April, May, and June, we're going to have to make up the difference. And so there were two invoices for 300 and, well, our share of it was $361.87.
So there were $1,000 a year?
No, so for 1 month, it's $361.87. We have 2 months that we need to pay now.
So there are two invoices of 361, so it's...
Well, there's two invoices, and our 15% share is $361.87. One of the corrections was that on last week's transfer, we had a slightly outdated expenditure ledger, which had reflected a small balance in 440, but there actually was already a deficit of $292.47. So basically, when you add up $361.87 and $361.87 and $292.47, which is the deficit, they're seeking a transfer of $1,016.21.
So that place costs $6,000.
About $2,500.
Okay. I'll do the math. 15% of $2,500. I think you should do the math.
I'll do the math.
If you didn't know math wrong. Yeah, I did know math wrong. Never mind. So anyway, and the other question is, does next year's budget already account for the increase, or are we going to do this again next year's time?
No, so next year's budget, I believe, was level funded at $8,700.
Okay, so we should look forward to doing this again next
potentially, year. But the thing is, Don Lowe pointed out to me last week when I spoke with him that there is sometimes significant fluctuation year to year. Like, there are years when it spikes, years when it's lower, and it's just based on usage. And so next year, maybe 8,700 will be enough.
That'd be a whole subject of discussion.
Right. Shut down the lovely lunchroom.
Is it hydraulic load or
rain?
I know they have problems over here.
Again, you got to start reading the contract.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay.
Anyway, so moved.
I'll second that.
Okay. All in favor, say aye.
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 Okay. And then the next transfer is, I think we sort of got a preview in our conversation with Joe Lynch that because of the recycling costs are so much higher, he was anticipating that we would need to do a reserve fund transfer to finish up at the end of this year. So, according to Mr. Lynch, the cost of recycling has risen and continues to rise due to a level-funded budget for FY19. The current budgeted amount is not enough to cover remaining charges. So, to get us through April and May, April and May, there's a request of $15,446.18.
So that's just 2 months. I'm curiosity. How much much is in our current reserve fund at the moment?
54,000.
Minus 15, minus 7 coming on next month.
Oh, right, yeah.
Okay.
We're going to be kind of close.
Okay. And if I recall correctly, we were actually fully refunding that as a result of our meeting. Is that right?
No, you mean...
It's a lower amount.
We replenished at 25,000. So...
Hold on, essentially, because you have 15 plus 7.
Right.
Okay.
Just checking. Yep.
So we have to have a special town meeting?
I don't think so. There are... let's cross that bridge when we get there. I don't think so.
You can always slump that.
Yeah. There are options. I haven't asked Minotchka and Don to explain.
What's our reserve for next year? I know it's a lot less.
No, it's 100,000.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought we had replenished it less than we needed to get to 100,000.
Okay.
I thought we had replenished it less than needed to get to 100,000. We didn't give it a full.
No, I think we replenished it to the full.
That was 100.
Yeah. So,
how will we pay for that bill? 15,000-ish?
15,000 is at 446.18. Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, great. That's all that we have in terms of transfers, and unless anybody has anything else that they want to discuss, I kind of was thinking anything sort of big picture strategy I would want to save until Connie's able to join us, but yeah, I think that's
the letter.
Right.
Oh, the letter, you want to save that? You're going to do the intro, right?
Yeah, and I think in addition to having Connie's input, there's still some research that I've been doing related to prevailing wage and pre-qualified and all that stuff, and I just want to make sure that we're sort of like we've got all of the right.
I think Bob's suggestion about running that by MMA is pretty important. They had a pretty good finger on the pulse of the legislature. My instinct tells me that the Democratic legislature, and I'm speaking as a Democrat, will not look kindly on any exemption from prevailing wage legislation, but maybe they will. I'm sure there are plenty of smallish towns or non-suburban towns are facing the same pressure that we are. That's right. Somebody has to start. Yeah, exactly.
Getting MMA is good.
Right.
And then just running it by a few people before
right.
we actually... is this doable? And
yeah.
If you were to do it, how would you go about it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And if you could get 300 towns to participate in the conversation. I mean,
it's a significant issue for us, and I'm sure for a lot of other towns too.
Anything else?
Nope.
Motion to adjourn?
I so move.
I'll second that.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All right, good night. Thank you.